down in the riders taking part in the Kieran, a new event on the calendar as far as the Olympics are concerned, and perhaps Australia might be in for a medal. This is Russo coming up towards the start line now. The atmosphere is absolutely electric. We said that many times before in our competitions, but I don't want to sort of blow the gap on the news that will come later on, but we've seen the Madison race. It's one of the most spectacular Madisons I've ever seen. Sorry we didn't bring it to, so slap on wrist for me mentioning, but Charlie Walsh down the track centre. We're now looking at Marty Nostein coming here, the coach for Australia. On the left-hand side, just nipping through there, we saw in the yellow jersey and the cheers coming up as Fiedler gets himself ready. The roar for a Nyman coming through here. That's Van Eyden, by the way, down there, next on the line. And we should be able to pick up Russo. So we've now seen Fiedler, Van Eyden, Russo, Nostein, Manier. And we didn't actually pick up Gary Neeb. He's at the top of the track. We'll probably pick him up with the camera. Go to the left. Anyway, he's up to the top there. There he is now. He's dedicated his life recently to getting a gold medal at the Olympics. And we've just seen, we've just seen Australia get a gold in the Madison. It was an outrageous, noisy party time here. And for Charlie Walsh, I've known for many years now, he's been 20 years the Australian coach, and he's retiring as at tonight. And in the last but one race, he's finally got Olympic gold, and we have to go back into Mike Turter, who's commentating for Channel 7, on the host broadcasters here, when Mike Turter got a gold medal in the Olympic pursuit team with Grenda, Nichols and Woods way back in 1984. So they waited all that time in the Olympics to get a gold medal. And there at the top of your track, a man, Neewand, who has ridden in the Olympics in the past anyway. He got a bronze medal in 1988 in the sprint and a silver in 1992. And he's now up against some serious opposition, because here Jens Fiedler, twice Olympic sprint champion, there in the yellow crash hat, the reigning champion, world champion for the Kieran. Well, if you've been watching our earlier program, you will have seen riders pushing and shoving, and I can almost say that the man who wins medals here, or the men that win them, are those who haven't been reprimanded by the judges. We've had riders relegated, we've had riders warning. In fact, 8 riders have been warned or relegated in the previous heat. So I think the final could be a really rough and tumble affair. So keep your fingers crossed as we're now in for a new event as far as the Olympics. And back at the ready, I think at the back, they've been the push and shove. They can't go past the lead bicycle there with the electric motor. They can come and overtake themselves if they choose to do so. Oh, they come through here. Neewand leads. Behind him is Russo. Wearing 44. The German in the blue and the white with the halved or quartered crash hat is Van Eyden. That's the yellow crash hat is Jens Fiedler. The big fellow with the red stripes on his pants is Marty Nostein, the sprint champion already, Olympic sprint champion. Marty in there. Jens Fiedler getting the third. This man here, so determined, so dedicated, comes from North Adelaide in South Australia, and bringing up the back end, tail end Charlie at the moment, is Frederick Manier, a very experienced rider indeed. Kilometre world champion in 95 and in 97. So we've got a lot of talent here. In fact, I'm looking down this lot, I can't see somebody who hasn't won 1, 2, 3 or even more world championships, or even with Marty Nostein, a gold medal in the Olympics. The final event on our programme is packed capacity, 6,000 crowd roaring on anything which is in yellow, and they're starting to move up now, and there'll be 2.5 laps to go. Suddenly over the top for Fiedler, unleashes a tremendous sprint then. Fiedler goes over the top very quickly indeed, and Neewand behind him looks over his shoulder to see what's going on behind him as they come down now, and it is still them. D1 looking back to see what's happening behind him as Russo starts to come at him now. Russo's going at him and Fiedler, Nieuwand and Russo. Nieuwand is going like a man possessed as he comes down here with one lap to go, and Nieuwand is going some, but Russo comes up to him and then Fiedler is behind him and leaving it very late is Nostein. Still then going, Nieuwand is building himself on this track here and behind those pushing and shoving. It may go to Nieuwand. What a day it'll be if they finish the goal as Nieuwand goes to the line. And, he missed it. He missed it to Russo. He missed it to Russo, and it might have been only a silver medal or bronze, I don't know, because suddenly surging through came a Fiedler at the last minute. What a finish. Russo certainly turned up the tap, got the gold, but my goodness, it was just by a wombat's whisker. I wouldn't like to say who was second there between Gary Nieuwand, who's desperately dedicated himself to getting a gold medal, congratulating Russo there, who's now got the gold in this new event on the calendar. There's his coach, Jelle Quintin. The disappointment there, but he didn't go down without a fight, did Gary? And the world champion, the Kieran world champion, was he second, was he third? I'll wait for the result. In fact, still hasn't come through, and looking at that one, I think that Gary might have got the silver. Well, silver to him would be a disappointment, having dedicated himself to getting gold for Australia, but my goodness, this whole race has gone out. A tremendous, tremendous racing here at the Dunk Race Stadium. Well, the presentation of the medals will be going there. It's a gold to Russo, the silver to Gary Nieuwand of Australia, Jens Fiedler of Germany coming up with the bronze medal. What a cracking 5-6 days we've had here. Yeah, 6 days it is now. I'm beginning to get sort of a bit, my head's going on the blink. I've enjoyed every minute of it. And for Great Britain to get those medals, it was an amazing, amazing Olympics we had here. And certainly Australians have welcomed everybody from across the world. 11,000 athletes have come here. And as far as cycling is concerned, this great Australian nation have a great tradition in cycling. Remember back in 1932, they got their first gold medal when Dunk Gray won that medal in 32. This stadium was named after him. The Australians then got gold just before we came on air, then just a silver now here. But I'm David Duffel. I've enjoyed every moment of this. And congratulations to the British team, too, for taking home a whole hatload of medals. Good on you, boys. It's time to say from the Sydney track here, g'day.